are called as Vayu, Shakuni, Kakaha. There are many names for birds. Amarakosha, many have read Amarakosha of Amarasimha. There are 44 verses. In Simhadi Varga, he has concentrated on different words. Cannot believe there are so many names of words he has quoted. Paravataha, Kalaravaha, Kapotota, Shashadanaha, Patrishena, Ulukastu. So it continues like many names in 44 verses of Amarakosha. Now the main concentration of Rig Veda, birds in ancient Indian literature. Sighting of birds in Vedas, starting with Rig Veda. Lifestyle of birds with a divine functions of devas. See how devas or gods are invited, taking the name of birds. Ashvina veha gacchatam nasatya mavi venatam hamsa viva patatam suta upa. This is fifth mandala of Rig Veda. You arrive for the sacrifice like pair of flying swans. So sages are inviting Ashvini devatas. Like you come, you please arrive to receive a prayer like swans. Why? Especially with swans, which can easily move both in water and sky. And shenasya jijivasa nutanena. You come with the utmost speed. You come with very speed to receive our prayer. Shena bird is really fast. And Haridra Veva Patato, the Kapota and the Uluka are condemned as birds of ill omen in Rig Veda. Special types of birds such as Kasa, Haridrava, Kiki Devi, I have translation, English translation for that. In another my presentation, Tva Shenaha Ivamam Uta Vaditama Suparnaha. Rigveda also suggests the preacher, Upadeshaka, the teacher, to preach like a Shakuna bird which flies, that is Brahmana, around in the sky. So, very interesting. The preacher, the duty of the teacher is to stand, it is not the duty of standing. We have to go around Brahmana. We should teach or we should preach for other students. No one should remove Uchatana you like Shena bird and Suparna bird. Nobody, Shena and other, normally the hunter will kill the birds. Here the sages are telling preacher or the teacher, he is telling about the teacher, Upadeshaka, no one should kill you like the hunter killing the bird. And this shloka is very much interested. Dov Suparna Sayuja Sakaya Samanam Ruksham Parishasva Jate. Two friends are sharing a common tree for their abode. Our Sharira is compared to a tree. In Sharira, there are two different birds. The tree is the human body and the birds are and the individual and the supreme spirit. That is, Sayuja means which have equal relationship. Sakaya means like friends. Here is Rupakalankara. Body is the tree and Jivatma, Paramatma are the birds. This is our body and we have our Jivatma. Each and every body has Jivatma and Paramatma is observing. Jivatma is enjoying everything in the life, but Paramatma is observing us. This is compared, there are two birds compared to two birds. Atharva Veda shows familiar, there is a shloka, Atharva Veda shloka, shows familiarity with birds of prey like the the falcon. And red-headed marlin who hunt in pairs, Shenu Sampati Nau. It says, the real meaning of the shloka is, or mantra is, our enemies should disappear like Shaina and Sampati birds, pass away by fighting each other. That is Shastru Damana. Our enemies, we should not hurt our enemies. Our enemies should always fight each other, and let them die. We are safer side. We are in the safer side. That is the mantra. By the time Atharva Veda came to came to be composed, the prejudice against the pigeon had disappeared. Indra is said to have helped a wounded pigeon with food and water. There is a reference of Indra and pigeon. Yajurveda Samhita, Shari, Ashwamedha Yaga. In Ashwamedha Yaga, there are plenty of birds, the name of plenty of birds. They had also observed the parasitic habit of the Indian pika, laying its eggs in the nest of crows and allotted it under the name of Anyavapa. So, Anyavapa means laying eggs in another's house like that to the half months, because it assigned the work of brooding on its eggs and bringing up the young to others. This is in Yajurveda Samhita. Yajurveda Samhita mentions about 60 birds in all in Ashwamedha Yaga and explains it, details how human beings can take help of animals and birds and should protect birds which have good quality of gods. Birds get happiness according to the season, Rutu. Here, Somaya Humsana Labhate Vayave Balaka. It means Soma, the god Soma, will get the Swabhava of Hamsa, Vayu of Balaka, etc. The 23rd shloka contains name of many birds like Kuturan, Uluka, Chaban, Mayura, Kapota, Lavapakshi. That Lavapakshi is, even now it is called as love birds. We call them as love birds. Sighting of birds in epics and Puranas, etc. Ramayana, Valmiki shloka originated from his shoka owing to the killing of the Krauncha Pakshi by the hunter. The Ramayana has started in the original Ramayana story has started because of Yat Krauncha Mituna Dekam Avadihi Kama Mohitam Manishyada Pratishtam. One hunter has killed one bird out of two birds, lovers. So then he got shoka, dukkha or sorrow. And due to his sorrow, shoka, he started originating shlokas. So bird is very important from the originality of the Ramayana. And then Ramayana was sung by the sage like the melodious singing of the bird Kokila, nightingale. Kujantam Rama Rameti Maduram Madhuraksharam Aruhya Kavita Shakam Vande Valmiki Kokilam. So we bow down to Valmiki like a Kokila. Kokila Pakshi means nightingale. And then Jatayu, you know the story of, if you know the story of Ramayana, obviously you can understand this. Jatayu is very much important in Ramayana. It was the one who wanted to save Sita from Ravana. And the monkey force of Sri Rama assuming the form of geese, Hamsa, in the air, Hamsavali Ivambare, attached the demon force of Ravana. If we observe the sky, the Hamsa Pakshis, how they fly in the sky, Hamsa Pakshi Riva, you have to fight against Ravana's force like Hamsa Pakshi. In Kishkindha Kanda of Ramayana, Rama explains Pampa Sarovara to Lakshmana, Hamsa Karanda Yuakinam Chakravakadi. So he takes many names of birds. If someone is very much interested, they can, hundreds of thousands of PhD can go on this subject. Mahabharata, Pandava, and the story of Mahabharata is based on Pandavas and Kauravas. Pandava, the word Pandava means Bakaha, Pandupakshi, white goose, and Kaurava, Kakaha, Kaka. They fight like Kakas, the crow. Aranya Parva presents Hamsa, Shuka, Pika, Kaka, Baka, and such other birds simply in a positive light. Form of flying of cranes, that is V-shape, is called as Pandavas when they fight against Kauravas. Shri Krishna suggests them to fight like Krauncha Vyuha, making Krauncha Vyuha. When Krauncha's, they fly in the sky, they sky like this, V shape, that is V shape, they like go like that. So it is easy to fight. If the army stands like this, that is called as Krauncha Vyuha. And general observations, Ahamsa, Shuka, Pika, Garuda all come in the Sanskrit literature. Royal practice of keeping pet birds, Damayanti and Hamsa story, they keep birds as even now in India many keeps birds at home. The birds tell the story, Shukana Sopadesha, the bird itself tells the full story. And Shakuntala carried her name, Abhijnana Shakuntala of Kalidasa, due to the Shakunta birds which protected her. The incident of Devas, including Indra, Agni and others taking the form of different birds, is depicted in the well-known Shibi story. Gods wanted to escape from animals in the form of birds. They were flying like birds, so nobody could recognize them. Hamsa Gamane, that is Kumar Sambhavam, reference of birds features in Natya Shastra. Bharata's Natya Shastra, he explained how we can act like Mayura Nritya, for example. Nritya is related to Mayura, like Mayura we can act. Kautilya Arthashastra also recommends many names. Now, birds as divine vehicles and sacred birds. Ancient Indians had recognized animals and birds right to coexist with the humankind, and therefore they were loved, nurtured and often worshipped. This is Garuda Vahana, Vishnu, Kaka Vahana, Shani, and the vehicle of goddess Saraswati, Hamsa, Mayura Vahana, Uluka. Uluka normally vehicle of goddess. Rarely people find this Uluka Vahane, that is Lakshmi. Uluka means oval. People think that oval is not good, fortunate. But oval is good due to Lakshmi. And some popular maxims coined after birds. I have quoted 8. All these maxims or Nyaya, all have different stories against them. Kakataliya Nyayaha, that's accidental. Kaka and Tala. Kaka just sits on the Tala Vriksha or a tree, and Tala Vriksha falls down. That is, Kaka is not related to it, but we compare it to Kakataliya Nyaya. Khale Kapota Nyayaha, Andha Kukuti Nyaya, Kakakshi Golaka Nyaya, that is, Andha Kukuti Nyaya is blind hand hen, Kakakshi Golaka Nyaya, crow and eyeball, Nirakshira Nyayaha, that is, teaches us the balance in life, Hamsakshira Nyayaha, scrutinizing for good things, the Hamsa Shvetaha, Bakashvetaha, Kobhedo, Bakasam Hamsa Yoho, Nirakshira Viveketu, Hamso Hamsaha, Bako Bakaha. The real Swabhava, the nature can be understood. Kakaha Krishnaha, Pika Krishnaha, Kobhedo, Kaka Pika Yoho, Vasantakale Prapte, Kakaha, Kakaha, Pikaha, Pikaha. Kaka is also in black color, Pika is also in black color. How can we differentiate Kaka and Pika? When Vasantakala comes, then when they both sing, we can understand which one is a singer, which one is not a singer. Okay, this is understanding real nature. Birds in community health and medicinal practices. Thousands of birds are used for medicine. But Manusmriti says, dharmataha, we should use birds only for the sake of medicine, not for eating, not for general eating. Okay. Even now, I worked in Ayurvedic Medical College for 7 years. They were using birds in front of me for the sake of medicine. They always say it should be used only for medicines, especially for pain, leg pains or vessel pains. They use birds. This Bharadwaja Pakshi, Kapinjala, Aati, there are, you can have a reference. so many names are there, and I'm concluding. Yeah, you can enjoy it again, it comes back. Birds. That's I conclude this paper with the note that according to the great Indian seers and sages of the ancient period, nature is like a vibrating veena. It has a perfect rhythm of life with waves in the form of all creatures, both flora and fauna. Fauna, my PhD, I got PhD long back. My PhD topic was fauna itself. Sanskrit literature always understood the nature as one comprehensive whole consisting of birds, animals, plants and others, forms and other forms of species living in a state of balance, harmony and equilibrium. The need of the earth is to realize that the rich biodiversity of the Mother Earth is too valuable to be destroyed by our callous and ignorant attitude towards nature. Now in India, the central government has started green revolution, Hasiru Usiru. It means the green itself is our breathe. It's very important. If I cut one plant, I have to replant at least five. In the same way, the birds and animals are also protected. Otherwise, we feel bad afterwards. Our grandchildren may not see. Already we are losing many birds. Garuda Pakshi, we are not having much Garuda and small birds. We may not, our great grandchildren may not see those birds. Then solution to any problem relating to birds should also be total and integrated in nature. This is so because problem in any one element would create problems and disharmony in other elements, and the entire system suffers. Hence, if we have to live happily, it becomes our sacred duty to make other living beings like birds on this earth and also happy, and create an environment livelihood to every species. Therefore, the motto should be treat every being with compassion, love and reverence. It is suggested in my paper that these names should be compared to the scientific classification of modern context of Indian birds and to identify them by local languages. I request scientists and science people to translate the names of these birds. We have translated some birds' name, but science words are different than English translation. So I request them. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramayaha. Thank you very much.